Hello everyone, Organizations for Google Summer of Code 2023 has been announced, and now I am pretty sure you are confused on how you should proceed. So this video will tell you what you should not do for Google Summer of Code 2023. So first thing first, choose one particular organization or at max two and select one of the repositories where you want to work in. So, you know, basically people tend to select multiple organizations and they work with multiple projects and they have a very clustered approach on going through while writing their proposal. So my suggestion would be select an organization or at max two and select one or two repositories where you want to work in. So how to select organization, I have made a video. So the link will be in the description. Check that out. Now, second thing is don't send spammy PRs. I can understand that when you are starting out and if you want to understand the workflow, it is easier for you if you can directly send some easy, like, you know, with basic changes pull request to understand how the workflow of the particular organization works. But don't send them a lot, right? Because ultimately the number of pull requests which you are sending does not matter a lot to us, but the quality of pull requests which you are creating is something which is more important than the numbers. So keep that in mind. So number three, don't worry if, you know, others are solving more PRs or they're interacting. The Google Summer of Code is not about competing with each other. It's about growing together and ultimately solving or contributing to open source, right? So don't have the attitude when you are competing with each other. Hey, can both of us do it together? So yeah, that shows that you are interested in solving problems together. So that's a good thing. But don't be like, hey, I guess you are taking a lot of time and I can solve faster than you, so I will be doing it. Number four, have your communication skills pretty clear. So communicate with your mentor and maintainers and try to understand what they want to achieve. Take help from them. It's like you need not do everything on your own. Like, understand what they want you to do, right? So initially, maybe the issue which you are solving or the proposed idea which you are proposing maybe is not that important as of now for them. But there might be something else that you can solve, but you are not able to understand what you can solve because you're not talking with them. So have a constant to and fro conversation with your mentor. Number five, so the proposal submission, in a lot of folks, they just stop contributing. So if you're aiming for Google Summer of Code and if you want to get selected as a mentee, keep contributing even after you have submitted the proposal. Because if you don't contribute post submitting a proposal, some of the mentors or maintainers might feel that the only journey you have was still the submission of proposal, the number of pull requests which you could have mentioned in your proposal. But have the sense of open source, right? Even if you're not getting selected in Google Summer of Code, you can contribute open source. That is something you need to know and you should keep in your mind. So once you've submitted the proposal, keep working on it. And even while writing the proposal, it is pretty tricky. So I have also made a video on how to curate the best possible proposal, so check that out. The link will again in the description. So if you have anything else in your mind and if you feel that you don't know, let me know. I will create another video on that. Until then, don't do the points which I mentioned, and all the best.